Well, joining us today for our Talanoa is MP for Mangere, Sua William Seo. Thank you for joining us.
Good morning.
Morning, Sua.
First of all, what did you think about the budget for our people?
Oh, look, I think from our perspective, it failed to really respond to the issues and the challenges that our communities are facing. And it also signalled that this government is increasingly out of touch with the reality that our communities are experiencing. I mean, rightly so, 9.9 million for the Pacific.
I heard you giggle a little bit when that was mentioned.
Well, it means that we're returning to what the funding levels were back in 2008 when this government took place. You see, this government has a habit of partially funding increase of costs from inflation and population growth and calling that more money.
Right.
So that's why.
Now, sort of one of the big issues that's happening at the moment is the homelessness, the yeah. people living in their cars. Has the government delivered in this budget?
No, look, the money that they've allocated is badly needed for the sector, but it isn't enough. It doesn't solve the problem, and they still don't have a comprehensive plan for addressing housing. Westpac identified last year that we needed to build 10,000, almost 11,000 houses per year. And at best, what their proposal will free up land for about 1,100 houses. And so today we've got 18 families living in Te Puia Marae because they've been living in cars and can't get housing.
There's the $250,000, that's a quarter of a million, especially for Pacific Island people to look at moving outside of Auckland. What do you think about that?
Yeah, so they're exploring and whether there are houses outside and jobs and whether there'll be support organisation. There might be some. There might be some. But if you're going to move people outside of Auckland, you want guaranteed jobs. You want to ensure that your children get good access to education, and you want some support around languages. There's nothing on languages, and so Pacific Education Centre, we don't know what's going to happen to them, whether they have to close shop at the end of this year.
We've got more money there for young people that are out of work, education and training. That's
Absolutely.
A good thing, surely?
And that's important. But here's the thing. We expect our governments to be funding those sort of things. We shouldn't be applauding them for doing what we expect them to do.
Just really quickly, because I know we're short on time, I noticed here a quarter of a million for a feasibility study for a cultural centre. What did you think of that?
Well, I would expect that money be available as contestable funding. I don't know how they're going to do that, whether it's in-house or whether they've got somebody that they'll appoint from outside. I'm not sure how that's going to benefit our communities long term.
I think it'd be good for tourism, for cultural tourism, for employment maybe?
I've heard that been said, but again, we don't know the details. I'd expect that money to be contestable to providers who know a thing or two about culture, who know a thing or two about tourism. I don't know. We don't have the details of that.
So we'll have to wait and see. Thank you for joining us on the show, and we'll come back more to the issue later as well. Well, after the break, Vodafone Pacific Music Awards finalist Annie Grace. I remember her talks openly about the challenges she's faced.
And it's bright lights, action and some great Pacific fashion at the Mena Fiji fundraiser.
I'm so proud to come and watch Pacific talent showcase tonight.